Hello everyone, my name is SiC, and welcome back to Steal the Fish in Normandy 44. This is going to be my second video for this game. After I soundly lost the first one, I figured I had to do better. And we're going to be playing another solo match for now. And maybe tomorrow I'll go for a multiplayer match, but right now I'm a little bit too intimidated because I got my ass handed to me by the AI, and I can't only I can only begin to imagine what other players are going to be doing to me if I don't really learn the game first. Sadly, the boot camp is disabled for now because it would have been really useful. So all we really have available to us is skirmish mode in single player. And I actually played a second match today and I managed to win it. And I was quite surprised by that because I got my ass handed to me so soundly in the first game. But I did set the player AI to easy instead of medium, so that helped a little bit. And I'm going to do the same thing now, but just because I want to show the game to you in a little bit more depth, because it is actually very interesting. The battle phases are pretty, pretty important and really, really help to change up the pacing of the game. Because I was set to win a major victory in my last match that I didn't record. Until we hit a battle phase C, and that is when the Germans got some really nasty firepower. Like, they brought out the long guns, and I was having trouble holding the ground that I took. So we're probably going to see something similar. We are going to be playing Axis versus Allies on Pointe Du Hoc. This is the map that I didn't play the last time. The last time I played Colombelle. But today we're going to be playing Pointe Du Hoc because I'm interested to see what this map looks like exactly. And we are going to be playing as, let's see, the 15 infantry, I guess. Yeah. I haven't made a battle group yet. And that is actually, basically, it's not a card game, but it's basically a deck of units that you create for a set amount of points. Alright, so you get like maybe 1,000 points. Each unit is worth a certain amount of points. And with those points, you can select what units you want to take. And there will be a limited amount of the units that you can take. So maybe you can only have 3 pieces of air support, and if they get killed off, then that is it. You're going to have to do without air support from that point forward in that match. So I actually haven't played as the 15th infantry, so I'm not entirely sure what they're going to get. And I also haven't played against the 12th SS Panzer, I don't think. So this is something new again. But yeah, let's see. We will go for a time limit of 30 minutes as before. So, let's get started. Alright, so, we're in the map, and we are, as you can see, on Pointe Du Hoc. And it's actually interesting, because I feared having to go up against these cliffs. That is what Pointe Du Hoc is famous for, but luckily, we will start at the top here. Looks like we have quite a lot of hedgerows, and this is going to be a battle for line of sights, apparently. We have a few open roads. This road looks like Ambush Alley to me. We could probably set up some nice infantry squads in here. And you can see when I mouse over the terrain, you can see that when it turns green, we have heavy cover. When it turns yellow, we have light cover. And when it's gray, there is no cover. So each little thing does have its effect. Most of the time, it's like almost 1 pixel large, this cover. This could do with being a little bit bigger, actually. Right, so taking and holding these hedgerows is very important. Setting up long sight lines with long range anti-tank guns is probably going to be important as well. We are going to want to take, probably there's going to be fighting around this area right there. There's going to be fighting along this area. Maybe we can have a very long range anti-tank gun. That would be very nice indeed. But most of the battle in the center is probably going to be a lot of infantry and fighting from forest to forest, or, you know, ridge line to ridge line. But let's have a look at what the kind of units that we get. So we have the basic recon units. Apparently these are the guys I played with earlier, and they look to be the British, not the Americans. And so that actually means I'm a little bit more familiar with these guys than I actually fought. So we have the Honey Stewart. It's a light battle tank. It is fairly okay. It's not great. We have support. Ooh, we already get some support units that are quite powerful, but it looks a bit like the Churchill 5, the AVRE. I have no idea how you're supposed to say that, actually. The Crocodile. Napalm. So this is like a flamethrower tank. This could be very useful indeed in this area right there. I think I'm going to go for one of these. But maybe a little bit later, because look at the cost. It's 165. You only get 500 and then 85 income every 60 seconds. So we have to spend our points wisely. So first of all, we are going to go for some infantry units. We are going to take a Bren group. Let's see, we will take a rifle group. We will take a rifle leader. We will be, of course, taking a recon unit as well. And maybe get some more regular infantry. Let's get another rifle unit in the center, because last time I actually was outnumbered in terms of infantry, and that cost me dearly. We are also going to take along a Honey Stewart tank. We're going to keep him in the rear until we know what kind of forces we are up against. We will also take some anti-tank units. Let's see, we have Lloyd Carry. I'm not entirely sure what the difference is between these two. They're both about basically the same amount of points. They seem to be the exact same thing. This is it. They have more experience. Same price, more experienced. So we will be taking this one along with me. Important thing to note is that all of these vehicles are actually towed by other vehicles. Or like, this is an anti-tank gun, but it has like a Bren carrier, I think. And so the anti-tank gun is actually behind here, and it's not deployed automatically. This is something I didn't really notice early on, but it's very important to note. All right, so we might also get some Spitfires. These might actually be very, very handy to have. So let's get one of those. And then we don't have the points anymore for the... where did I see it? The Crocodile. Yeah. So we're going to have to save up a little bit. We might actually go in like this for now. Try to see if we can form a center in the middle there. And then we can call in the one of the support guns later on, maybe. Alright, so this is our... I choose war, really? Right, you're going to be on the road. We should probably just line these up a little bit. These are all trucks. We will have our Stuart tanks somewhere to the rear. This guy somewhere to the front. This is our commander. He's probably going to go along the back here as well. All right. At your orders, Captain. Let's get started. You guys are all going to go move fast. Understood. Move to this point. Looks like some units are actually quicker than others, so maybe we should have, like, I don't know if this is in the game, I haven't seen it yet, but it would be really nice if we had, like, a way to, basically select a formation for these units to be in. Alright, so, let's see. You will unload here. You will unload here as well. Let's see, where is our anti-tank gun? There is our anti-tank gun. He is going to unload right there. The Honey Stewart is going to hide in here. Maybe for now, control that area. Commander. Let's see. Unload that position. I should really try to learn these shortcuts as well. Commander is going to go there.
At your orders, Captain.
Unload that position. You're going to go there. Yeah, you're going to unload as well. And let's see.
What's up, Captain?
You guys are going to deploy right there. Recce units are going to deploy maybe... I don't know, maybe there, see what's up. Honey Stewart is going to be in the rear. Commander Carrier is going to hide out right there. And now it looks like the enemy is approaching. Like, my right flank is about to collapse. I think we will be taking a Honey Stewart tank. We'll be taking some infantry. Maybe quite a lot of infantry. A rifle leader, to be sure. He's going to be in the rear there. And let's take another Bren group right there. Luckily, we're very close to our deployment zone, so that should not be too much of a problem. Did you actually drop off your guys? No, you did not, but now you have. Alright, excellent. Let's take these units over in this ridge line so we can get a clear line of sight over there. It looks like they're not actually advancing over here, so I'm going to advance instead of them.
Let's roll.
all my infantry groups are. Let's see, you're going to move there. You're going to move there, and actually, you should probably move there. As for this, looks like we are pushing them back. We are exerting some zone of control. The commander is going to stay right there. You're going to deploy right there. You're going to deploy right there. And the steward is going to control the road for now. Let's see, maybe we should actually put you there. No contacts with the enemy so far. If we do get into trouble, I can call on my Spitfire, which is actually very important. These guys are just going to control this area, or keep an eye out and see what's going on. These guys are going to be my main battle line. This guy is going to support us. They should probably...
Wake up, boys. It's not tea time.
Yeah, you're going to move over a little bit. My six-pounder should take their position, if at all possible. Yeah. There we go. Hopefully it will have a good line of sight from that position. I'm not entirely sure. Alright, maybe we should get some recon over in this area as well. And actually, it looks like we are in control over here, so we will unload these guys over there. These guys are going to back them up. You're going to move over there, because these guys are actually not supported by anything at the moment. And you're going to move into those buildings. Alright. Maybe at this point we should bring in our support tank. Let's bring out our crocodile. There we go. Man, I can't believe I still haven't seen any Germans. But you can see they're probably somewhere around in this area, so we're actually... yeah, I think we're basically doing a pincer move over here.
This is a story you'll tell your grandchildren.
Let's hope so. Let's hope you survive to tell this story to your grandchildren. But we will see.
Everybody, check your ammo.
Alright, let's move you guys forward. You as well.
Platoon formed and ready.
Let's see. Man, this cover could use some improvements. That is for sure. Alright, you're going to move right there. You're going to move right there. The Honey Steward tank is actually probably... Yeah, he's going to control our left flank. Along with this guy. Our recon unit is going to move forward, and our commander carrier should probably stay pretty close by as well. And our crocodile, he is going to hang out in this clearing as well. This area is wide open, and I think the AI actually realizes that they could be in a lot of trouble. So let's bring out another anti-tank gun. We're going to deploy them right there. We're going to have some regular infantry. Their unit, those units are pretty cheap, so I'm going to be taking a few of them. Let's see, let's have one unit in that forest right there. In they come. Where the hell are these Germans keeping? And what is really interesting in this game compared to war game is that in war game you had areas on the map that you had to control. Like you would have like a circle, and in that circle you would have to place your commander unit, and only with that commander unit would you be able to control that area. You have nothing like that here, we just have the front line. And it's crazy that these guys are simply not advancing.
Yes, sir.
So I will be doing it instead. Let's see, our brain groups will move forward, our humble... Actually, probably a recon ship move first, but oh well. You're going to move forward. These guys could probably hold up in the same area. Let's move them up fast towards this crossroad right there. Ah, there we go, finally. Alright.
Yes. At your orders, sir.
No line of sight. The line of sight is blocked by these buildings. That makes sense. But once line of sight is made, and they should be making line of sight pretty soon, like past this street, we will actually be in a good position to take a shot. Alright, let's move you forward.
Command,
our Honey Steward is going to control the left flank. The crocodile is actually going to go over there as well. Alright. It's interesting, because in my last game, you know, the one that I didn't record, the AI was a little bit more aggressive than this, so they seem to be holding back here a little bit. I don't know if they have, like, problems pathfinding through all of this stuff. I can't imagine that they would have. But it is a fact, like, the last mission was a little bit easier So let's see, we have 2.5 minutes until phase B, and in phase B we will be able to take this artillery, so I'm going to save up for this a little bit. Maybe we should get another tank. No, I want to wait for C as well. Like, or B. I want to wait for B before I call in more. Right, we have enemy units on the left flank. That is important information. They have, what is this? It looked like an anti-air vehicle. I'm not entirely sure.
Tank ready.
Let's move the tank over there. Let's also get some infantry units over in this area. Let's also get a rifle leader squad.
We're listening to you.
A recce unit should probably move along. Wow, I can't believe that these guys are still going safely. Alright, I'm going to move them up and we're going to have a solid front line here. I'm just a little bit worried about my left flank at this point, so let's get these guys to move fast towards, let's see, this position. Because if they move fast, they're actually using the roads, but it also makes them easier for ambush. If they're not moving fast, they will just drive through the terrain. That is the big difference there. Alright, these guys are getting very close, I think. Hopefully this unit is going to be able to hold the line. We're also going to get some more infantry up in this flank, I suppose. Alright, I'm really hoping that these guys are not going to be ambushed, but I think the recce unit is going to take care of that for us. Yeah, good. Alright, we're going to have to get into line of sight. We're going to be pretty soon. Yep, got that shot. Crew killed. Oh wow, that was really nice. Excellent. All right, and you can see the front line retreating there as well. So there were only a few units. Let's get these guys to move forward. We should probably unload them right there, and we are having more contacts over here, like a pack 38. All right, so we have not infantry.
Yes, sir.
These guys automatically disengage as well, which is really, really good.
We'll deploy at this position.
All right, like these guys noticed they were under fire, and so that's why they actually decided to get out of their vehicle. Their vehicle is probably destroyed because I don't see it anymore.
Ready to transport.
All right. Oh, their vehicles just disappear, apparently. Interesting.
Moving the gun, sir.
Just unload right there, please. Alright. So we seem to have a handle on things. You're going to unload right there, and our recce unit.
Need some extra eyes, sir?
Yes, we do. Let's get you over there. Our Stuart tank is going to move over there.
Yes, sir.
You're going to unload right there.
Let's go, Lieutenant.
Man, this is actually kind of boring. Let's move these guys forward. Let's move these guys forward. You're going to move forward. You're going to move forward. And our Stuart tank is going to go right there. Like, I don't want to rush this.
Ready, sir.
So I'm just going to move these guys up gradually. Surely but slowly. We're going to move these guys over to the flank as well. Our anti-tank gun is going to stay in this position. Finally, we are under fire a little bit more. So, yeah, they're very close now. We're going to pull these guys back. Let's see. Can we? No. Recce destroyed. Alright.
Everybody, check your ammo.
You're going to move forward. We definitely need them in position. You are going to move right there. These guys
ready,
should probably just move up to this battle line. Or actually, maybe our rifle unit can move right there. The Bren group is going to hang out over here. What's that guy just singing?
Engine is running. We're waiting. Germans ahead.
Alright, now we're getting into it again. We've got the Bren supporting, these guys are being pinned down, they need to fall back. Our fire team leader should hang out in the forest over here. You should probably hang out over here. And actually, let's see. Could you? No. I don't think you can. Let's get some infant, or let's get some air support in here, because these guys are being pinned down by this guy, and I don't like it one bit. Oh, that might be. Let's have a look. Ooh, this guy might be anti-air. Yep. We should probably switch priorities there. Why are you not firing? You're not pinned down yet. Alright, we have so much support. Actually, let's get some tanks in here as well. Let's get a Churchill up the main road. Let's get another Churchill up the side road. Let's get some support units, as in the Crocodile. I want the Crocodile over here. Let's also get some more air units, because that is going to be very, very nice. And actually, I want to save up for this guy, the Typhoon AT. I think that guy would be excellent. Alright, let's have these guys fall back to this line over here. Hopefully this infantry is going to advance. They're not going to have line of sight until they're very close, and then we will just take them out. This guy needs to retreat as well. You definitely need to retreat. Let's have you move over here once you're back and listening to commands.
Second platoon ready, sir.
Alright, our support group should move up. Oh, we have infantry contacts on the left. There we go. We have infantry over here as well. Let's get our Spitfire to move. Oh, that's anti-air. No, we're not going to move our Spitfire over there. Oh, that's not the button I'm looking for.
Copy, leader.
God damn it. No. Actually, yeah, let's send him over there. See if he can take out this this vehicle, because it is messing up our Stuart tank. Yeah, this thing is really not good for us. Alright, we have our Churchill tank though. So, that guy is going to move over there. Our Crocodile unit should probably move into the into that field right there. Our Rifle unit should move over there. We can probably use some more infantry. Let's get a Rifle group right there. Let's get a Rifle leader unit right there. Alright, looks like we have some more contacts on the right hand side. Things are starting to heat up, and you are not going to last very much longer. You are going to have to retreat. Evac. That's evac out of there. Oh yeah, this is definitely not good. We have bogeys on our tail. Oh, crap. Ah, fuck. Actually, that calls for some anti-air units. Let's get this vehicle up in here. That should provide some support. Let's get this guy over there, and maybe we can take a Bowforce unit up over here.
Attention.
You're going to move quickly up there.
Let's go and fast. Yes, sir.
Yeah, let's move you up there. Let's make all of our infantry move up. You're going to stay in the line for now, or in the tree line.
Grab your stuff and move.
Looks like the Germans have a little pocket over here as well. So I'm going to do a very unwise thing and just send my Crocodile in. That is not smart, because it might be ambushed by infantry. Ooh, looks like we messed up one of their vehicles for once. Excellent. This guy is falling back. We have some infantry in the center. Not a whole lot though, so they're going to be pushed back, no problem, I think.
Stay on your guards, gentlemen.
You're going to move forward. You're going to move forward into those buildings.
Setting up, sir.
And you, our anti-tank gun, should probably nestle up in this building somewhere, or actually let's have you in low cover.
Hurry
be able
up,
to
man.
Shoot down this road, that would be very good.
Office is ready.
I'm gonna need to move forward. Our brand group should then support them from the buildings, and we should definitely get some more infantry. Let's get a rifle squad up in here. Or two. Two rifle squads and a leader with a Stuart tank. Yep. I like the sound of that. Oh, no, they only have four units. They're not going to accomplish much, but wait till we get to the late game. Like, Battle Phase C is about to begin in like 3 minutes. And that is going to be the decisive one. That one is going to mess things up for us. Alright, you guys are going to move forward, because I'm not liking this. Can you? Yep, or you could, but oh man. Alright, we need some recon units up in here as well. Let's get some recce units right there. Let's also get a recce unit up over here. You guys are doing quite well. These guys, I can't believe these guys haven't fallen back yet. That's absolutely crazy. But they're panicking slowly but surely, so. No line of sight. Why the hell can't you see these guys? Something's blocking. Oh, these roads probably. There we go. Fire at will. Nice. The enemy team owns 90 of the conquest points needed to win. Why? What is this conquest points that we're talking about here? Because I'm not seeing it. Right. Oh crap. We need support. Let's make sure that we send you into cover. Alright, and at this point we should probably look into artillery as well. Let's get a Churchill OP, yeah. You're going to go up the center. Can we get two? No, not quite yet. Not quite yet. That would be lovely, but no luck so far. I would like some some air support, but we're not going to get that either. I mean, I control so much of the map, right? Or at least I think I do. Oh, crap. Shooter knocked out, really? You need to reverse the hell away from there. And you guys should move up. Maybe I'm being too complacent. Maybe I should move out more. Actually, I definitely should move out more. Alright, you're going to move over there. Please don't kill my crocodile. Actually, you guys should be able to get line of sight there. But I'm not entirely sure why they're getting these victory points right now. That is my main concern there. Like, I have no idea what's going on here anymore. They should have total victory in 38 seconds? Why?
Everybody, check your ammo.
Alright, let's move these guys into close range. Is it maybe because they have more commanders on the map than I do? That could be a thing, maybe. I don't know. I'm definitely missing something here. Yeah, he's definitely singing there. Oh crap, I'm moving these guys forward and immediately they're just under fire. Alright. Luckily I have support with a tank, so they're actually not in any real trouble there. Well, total defeat. I have no idea why that is happening. I have 0 points? Really? Really? Alright, so we have a history of people killing and stuff like that. Shooter, Christian, blah blah blah, alright. Losses, we didn't even lose very much. And then again, I suppose the enemy didn't lose very much either. Alright. Well. Care to explain this one to me, gents? Please do so in the comments below. Alright, so that was my second video for Steel Division Normandy 44. Please leave a like and a comment below if you enjoyed this content and want to see more, and please let me know what the hell I'm doing wrong. And it's so annoying to me, like the one game that I didn't lose, I didn't record. That was, that's just bugging me right now. Anyway, I'll see you guys for the next video.